the 105th anniversary of the Franklin Band. I was off by about 45 years. The 105th year. We have quite a nice concert, and we have quite a few reunion people, people that played in the band for years. And I think you'll find it very enjoyable. Now, would you all please stand for the Star Spangled Banner? You might not be familiar with, because it was written by the father of one of our own band members, Holly. Holly's father actually moved to Franklin to be a part of the Franklin Band. And during the 50s, he started playing with the band, and he enjoyed it so much that he wound up conducting for about 10 years into the 70s, and he did the bicentennial, right? And at the time, he was the director, he was the business manager, he was the president, he was everything. And I guess he just loved doing it. And this piece, the piece we'll play for you next, is actually a piece that he wrote for the band.
Thank you. Thank you.
to just play it without giving you a little tiny background? It's really, the whole name of it is called The Eighth Candle, Prayer and Dance for Hanukkah. And as most people know, Hanukkah is a celebration of the victory of the Maccabees over the Syrians about a couple thousands of years ago. And when they reclaimed their temple, and they lit the menorah, and when they looked, they only had enough oil for one day. So the next day, you know, they said a prayer, and they got up, and they, just for fun, they lit it again, and it lit. And it kept lighting for 8 days. And what was really special about that is that was just enough time for them to replenish their supply of the sacred oil. So the piece starts out very quiet because it's a prayer. And since this is the eighth candle, this is the last day they needed it to light, and it lit. So it's quite a celebration at the end. I hope you enjoy it. So we'll play for it now, the eighth candle.
Thank you.
day, but Russia. So every time you hear a weird little section, maybe you either come to a town or a mountain or a valley or a prison. But Russia. What's the choice? Russia. Historian about the band and a few other things. Oh,
hi.
There he is.
And it's Bill.
Bill.
Yes. Yeah. Close. That's my brother.
Well, Bill.
Oh, well, I'm going to do it from here.
Okay.
Can people hear me?
No.
Can I borrow that?
And people hear me now? I'm delighted to be here today to participate with this, it's either 105 or 150th anniversary. I think it's 150, let me see.
Yes.
Oh, yes, it is. Okay, so this is 150th anniversary of the Franklin Band. It's unbelievable how they were able to sustain it consistently through all those years. I mean, that's many generations. You figure 7 or 8 generations of people, and it continues with, there's a few of the people that have had a 75 or 100 year family connection with it. For me, I got 3 relatives that have been here. Regina Ramage, wherever she went. Okay. And her cousin, Diane Ramage, on the flute, and Jeff Garrity. He's in the back. So just to show the tight connection through the years for the Franklin Band. I have a slideshow here. I've got about 50 slides, so I'm going to do it quick because I only want to be about 10 minutes. And so here we go. And I'm going to try to do this at the same time as I am speaking. Now, one would ask that why is the Franklin Band still in have life through all of these years? Somebody should do a research project on it, maybe. And one of the things that I would say is because of the mining that took place in the town. There's what we would call minerals in the ground, mining that took place, and the miners and their families that came here. Because everyone I just spoke of and my family came here for the mining of ore for making America great. There's 2 major minerals that are in here, in the ground, in the town of Franklin. One of them is iron. I have a piece of iron here I just picked up off the ground, and a magnet will stick right to it. And the other, and that took place in the 1870s until about 1900. And the other ore is zinc, one of the largest zinc mines in the world. And also because I don't know if you can see this or not, but it glows in the dark. Many of the minerals do. So Franklin is known as the fluorescent mineral capital of the world. We have our rooting in to be, have Franklin Knight to be the state mineral. That would be nice to see. But I want to show you quickly, because it's connected to the Franklin Band. I had to use some ingenuity here because the screen's broken, so I hope you don't mind. The iron ore place, if you look at my left-hand arrow, that shows where the original mine was, 1760s. Then there was a new one off to the left, 1870s. And then the building with the middle arrow is probably what was Dunlop's barn. And off to the right is the Iron Master's house. So that was the iron ore. There's another view of it. And there's another, this view is of the zinc mining, which was one of the largest zinc concentrating plants in the world from 1900 to 1950s, roughly. And this is what I consider to be the core of the nexus of the genesis of where the Franklin Band came from. You'll see some miners with mining helmets, carbide lights, at a football game, and they're out there playing with the dungaree jackets that some of you old people, older than me, would know. And we have some artifacts here. The 1873, the Franklin Furnace Band, Franklin Cornet Band, that the name congealed over the years, as we will see in our quick show. And it took place in Munson's Grove, which is down by Brick and Brew, who I see helped with the as a sponsor. And this is probably the oldest picture of the Franklin Band. I would say 1880s, nobody really knows. But if you look at the barn that's in the back, back left, That's probably that Dunlap's barn that I showed you in the first photo from, and that photo was from the 1890s. Here's some names. Some of these names still continue on. Addicts, Treelords, Stevens. And where did they play? This is a view of the farmer's picnic that would take place in August. 10,000 people would go there, and people from Franklin would get on the train at Franklin Junction and go over to Lake Girard. And here's a view of Schuster Park, which is where it's now known as Fireman's Park, and that was made by the New Jersey Zinc Company. One of the major players in the Franklin Band was Stephen A. Bendis. He is of Hungarian descent, and some of his relatives are here today, right there. And so, you know, there's some more continuity in the band, spirit of it. This is a view, probably from the Franklin School, of the Hungarian band, which he had put together. And the band was very similar to, has anybody seen the Music Man, 1950s? Exactly like it, except I don't think he was a shyster. The guy came into town. And that's a view of it. There's another view of the Hungarian band, which again, congealed into the Franklin band. And there's the Franklin boys band, just like in the movie. They had a boys band, my dad's in the middle section there as a boy. And another view of the Franklin band. This is an early view of the band coming up Main Street in Franklin, up near where the theater would be. And this view is from where the B.D. Simmons coal pockets would be. This one is what's in the bank in the middle of town at Moxie's, Moxie Midlands. And a couple of years ago, my mother, who is sitting back there, came to me and says, oh, I found this photo. On the back of the photo, it's got a bunch of information, and it says it was Memorial Day, 1923. Some of those uniforms we'll see as we get to the end of the slideshow. So the next year, being an avid historian, I climbed up on top of P.D. Simmons' coal bin and took this picture, which is, if you look back, it's in the same location as the other one was. All right, so there we went back, and now we're going forward, same connection. And also, with fire department, the same old pumper that they had right in front of Webb's newsstand, just like it was in 1923 and 2015, to show the continuity of the Franklin area, the Franklin Band, Fire Department, Main Street, USA. Another view, Chief Irons in the front, probably late 30s, and they're coming up High Street from where Morley Shirts would be eventually. Another view of the band, and I'll go through here quickly. This is at the foot of Main Street, 1960. We'll see some of the uniforms, and the uniforms were in the back on the table there if you wanted to see them. And with DeMario's behind it. And this one was 1976, new uniforms. It's the bicentennial red and white and blue uniforms. One from 1988, another view. This is up at High Point. High Point, the Veterans Monument, is that correct, Steve? And another trip that they made to the USS New Jersey down in Camden, isn't that a beautiful photograph? Another view of them in the Newton Parade fairly recently, and a very close connection to the Franklin Mineral Museum, again, tight-knit community. Out in the back, the Mineral Museum. This is Diane. I see you on the Glockenspiel there. Left and left. This is in the cemetery for. Do you guys remember what that was for? Memorial Day. Okay. And there they are at the end of the normal parade on Memorial Day at the Memorial Day marker. Coming around the corner at the pond, and here is the enthusiasm of the immigrants that came into the Franklin area to work and gain a livelihood for them and their families. The lively music that I've heard today from the spirit of the Franklin band continues, and I love seeing that. Theater, which was one of the largest theaters between New York and Pittsburgh in 1913, they helped participate with some of the Pitt Crew Orchestra, as you can see there, in the newfangled Franklin Theater. Another view of some immigrants coming up, participating and joyous about being here in America. Another view, notice all American flags. And the zinc company is behind it. Here's some scouts right after World War I. Cornish Cornet Band, Hamburg Cornet Band, Sussex Band, Lafayette Cornet. There was a lot of bands that took place for a while, but the Franklin Band continued. We have some artifacts courtesy of the Franklin Minnow Museum, and they're on the table down there. Thanks, Judy Williams. And this one is the oldest one. From what I can see, the uniform is from 1880s. So this is verifying that the guys were there. And the hat shows up on that ancient photo that is there. Doing a little research, it came from the Henderson and Company down in Middle Jersey. And this was owned by John Postis. And that hat has FFB on it. Anybody got an idea what FFB stands for? Franklin Furnace, the original name from the 1760s. And here's another uniform, Franklin Band, from the 1930s through the 50s, as you can see in some of the photos that we looked at. Again, from Franklin Historical Society. And here's another one, probably from the 60s through the mid-1970s. And I could verify that because that's me standing there with that uniform on. Thanks, Mom, for the program. Again, here they are with the new uniforms that they have, the red, white, and blue. And this is a view in later of where the Dunlop's barn was. And here is a typical trophy that they won because they are the award-winning Franklin Band, and I certainly second that opinion for them. So I would like to now welcome Dawn Fantasia, committee person, county commissioner, Dawn Fantasia, who is here to offer something for us.
Hi, I'm Dawn Fantasia. I'm actually a Franklin resident. I'm the director of the Board of County Commissioners, formerly Freeholders, if you recognize that name. I am happy to present a proclamation to the band on behalf of the Board of Commissioners, and I'd like to read it for you. We did read it into record at our meeting as well. Whereas the original Franklin Town Band was once known as the Franklin Furnace Band, organized in 1870, and whereas one of the oldest photographs of the band depicts members dressed in Civil War uniforms, and whereas over the years there have been fourth and fifth generation members in the band, whereas marching music celebrates all varieties of the art forms, bringing us music on the move. And whereas from the training field to the battlefield, the football stadium to the Broadway stage, small gyms, auditoriums, and grand arena spectacles, Pfeiffer, Piper, buglers, drum corps, marching bands, and others bring music to life to the delight of performers and spectators. And whereas the Franklin Band in their concerts and marching band are comprised of members that have performed for over 50 years, several over 30 years, and many over 10 years. And whereas many members that once laid their instruments down after school picked them back up again more than two decades later to perform in concerts and marches. And whereas the Franklin Band is the only community band still in existence in Sussex County. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Sussex County Board of County Commissioners hereby recognizes, honors, and appreciates the longevity of this county institution and its members, which produce music as varied as the ensembles themselves on this band's 150th anniversary. By order of the Board of County Commissioners, Don Fantasia, Anthony Fasano, Sylvia Patillo, Herb Yardley, and Chris Carney. Congratulations to all of you. Make us proud.
Thank you, Don. Well deserved by them. And also, last but not least for this intermission, is our state senator, Steve Oroho.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you for the presentation. And I'll be very short. I'm here with my wife, Rita, right in the back. And we are also Franklin residents. We actually live in the former Mayor Jenkins house up there on Ezra Road. So we also have a very nice proclamation, but a resolution from the state. And I can tell you it's in safekeeping because we had a miscommunication and it's at the office and it's got a lot of wherefores, whatnots, and why nots. And it's all about how good the Franklin Band is. And for 150 years, and they're the oldest community band in the state of New Jersey. So congratulations. Just for, and Dawn and I, and all the other elected officials, had the opportunity to march in a lot of the parades, and it's so great when you get to see the Franklin Band there and their uniforms, and it's just fantastic. So thank you very much for all you do on behalf of the Sunderland Park and Space and the Sunderland Howell Works and myself. We sponsored the resolution. It's official record for the state of New Jersey, and we promise we'll get it to the Franklin Band. And I'm sorry it's not here with me today, but thank you so much. Congratulations. 150 more.
And now we'll start the second half of the concert. And we ended the first half with a sleigh ride through Russia. I don't know if it's a song. Anything. But anyway, this is an American sleigh ride. It's written by Leroy Anderson, and I found out that he didn't write it as a holiday song. He wrote it, and he started it in 1946, and he wrote it during a heat wave. So I think maybe instead of Christmas, he was thinking about wishful thinking that the weather would cool off. So this is sleigh ride. Took him 2 years to finish.
Thank you.
try to play another holiday song, but I'm not going to announce what it is because you all know it. But if you're under 60 or so, you might want to start looking around because it could be a creature out there from a snowy area. Piece and see if we can conjure up some more creatures.
Thank you.
the last piece that the band's going to play by itself after this piece. Let's see. After this one and another creature piece, the Bionian people will be coming up. And before they come up, I just want, like, for everybody in the band to stand up. Robert, the band president, he asked me if I would mind conducting, and I thought, yeah, this might be fun, and it is fun. And we all mess up. I mess up a lot. But anyway, it's been a pure pleasure conducting them, and they're a great bunch of people, and I really enjoy this. So the next piece we'll play is, this is appropriate for me, somewhere in my memory.
Thank you.
You need to crack them to make them glow. Crack them. Rock them and shake them. Crack and shake. I'm not making this up, she's telling me. Has everybody gotten their glow stick? Yeah? For you. The next piece we'll play is a Christmas sing-along, and we're going to be listening to you sing.
Thank you.
Up here, we've prepared one of the probably the most famous marches, Stars and Stripes. You can get knocked if you still have your sticks.
Thank you.
very merry holiday. Thank you all for coming tonight.